quickly. So the title of our presentation is Spinker Sovereign Trinuclear and Protonated Tetranuclear Iron 2 Complex in DFT Modeling. So the phenomenon of Spinker Sovereign was discovered more than 19 years ago. It was a work of Cambi. This phenomena attracts attention to a very promising application in smart pigments, optical switches, memory devices, molecular electronics, and spintronics and displays. The most interesting effect is demonstrated by the ferrum II ion. In the octahedral field, the five orbitals of the d-electronic shell is split, and at low temperatures, the electrons are paired, and the spin of the metal ion is equal to zero. And under the action of the temperature pressure of the light, the ion switches to the high spin state with the spin equal to 2. The interesting thing is that the scientists looking for the complexes with the more interesting, more strong effects of the spin crossover, thus they increase the number of the ferrum ions, of the metal ions participating in the spin crossover, and this allows to obtain two interesting things. It allows to increase the temperature of the spin transition and to increase the difference between the magnetic susceptibility values at low and high temperatures. One of the representative of this compounds is a trinuclear compound. It was published a paper in 2017. You can see the structure of this interesting and beautiful compound. It also looks very nice in the direction of connecting these ferrum ions. And at the low temperatures, the spin value of the complex is equal to zero, and the magnetic susceptibility is also equal to zero. With the increase of the temperature, the spin transition takes place at around 380 for 20 K. And then the complex acquires a maximum spin value equal to 6, and the magnetic susceptibility is equal to almost 9, that describes very good the spin transition. To describe this spin transition, the authors also decided to measure precisely the structure of the complex at different temperatures, and they investigated the average bond lengths for the central metal ion and for the terminal metal ions. And they showed that this the change of the bond length corresponds very well to the change of the magnetic properties. This complex is the first one in which all three ferrum ions undergo a spin transition all together. Before, in previous complexes, only the central ferrum ion was participating in the spin transition. And this why this complex is very interesting. And the authors also were interested in to determine which one, which of the ferrum ions is the leading during this spin transition, the central or the two terminal ferrum ions. And the other complex is a tetranuclear complex. It was another complex which contains already four ferrum ions. The change of the properties in this complex is accompanied not by the light, temperature, or by pressure. The authors decided to modulate the magnetic properties by the chemical weight, and it was possible by a good choice of the hydrazine-based dystopic isomeric ligand, actually four ligands, and using these four ligands, they managed to assemble this beautiful cluster. And with the increase of the base, this system loses the protons attached to the ligand, and this is manifested in the change of the optical and magnetic properties of the system. Now the aims of our work is to explain the peculiarities of the spin crossover transformation in the trinuclear complexes with the aid of the single point drift calculation to determine either the central or the external metal ions are playing the leading part in the process of the spin transformation in the trinuclear system, to explain the peculiarities of the spin crossover transformation in the tetranuclear complexes, and to determine the effect of the protonation of complexes, tetranuclear complexes, on the course of the spin crossover transformation. The first, we proceed to the trinuclear complexes. The authors of this paper managed to give us, or just to the audience, a very good set of the crystallographic data that we used. They also, so we had a set of 15 crystallographic structures measured for different temperatures, and this allowed us to obtain very beautiful picture of single point energies for the different temperatures. At low temperatures, we can see that the ground state of the complex is takes the spin value equal to zero, and the other states with spin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 have the higher values. In the region of the spin transition, the energies are very close, and above the temperature of the spin transition, the ground state of the complex is already the one with the spin equal to 6, and followed with the states with the spin 4, 5, 2, 3, and 0, and 1, respectively. Here in this table, we presented the numerical values of the calculated energies. And here, just I decided to add the picture of the change of the average bond length for the ferrum ions, just to show that the change of the distances is also corresponds very well to the picture that we managed to obtain during our single point Giffey calculations. Just I will show the middle part, middle section of this Giffey single point calculation, and we will try to understand which are the ions participated, which are the ions actually the, represent the driving force in this Tinkercell transformation. If we look at the bond lengths at 315 K, so we can see that the ferrum 2 ions possess three bonds with a little bit higher values than the ferrum 1 ion. And already at 320 K, when the spin transition takes place, the ferrum 2 ion also possess a group of three bonds which are a little bit bigger than have a higher magnitude than the bonds of the ferrum 1 ion. So we can say, based on this calculation and looking at this picture, we can observe that at 320 K, the spin of the complex is equal to 4. And then it immediately changes to the value equal to 6. But looking at this energy and at the spin of this state, and looking at this value, we can assume that the leading driving force in this spin crossover transformation is belongs to the two terminal ferrum ions. The next is the temperature dependence of the single point energies corresponding to the spin values 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8. Here for the tetranuclear cluster, we also used the crystallographic data in our calculations. And we started to investigate the energies, single point energies of the protonated, fully protonated tetranuclear complex at low and high temperatures. When the complex is fully protonated and has eight protons, so at low temperatures, the ground speed state of the complex is equal to zero. So all the centers are magnetically silent. And at the high temperature, the spin of the complex is equal to 4, which shows that the two ferrum ions undergo spin crossover transformation. Looking at this table, we can see that this is probably the ferrum 1 and the ferrum 4 ions, which have with average bond length equal to 2.15. The same calculation was performed for the complex with the 6 protons. With the addition of base, the complex lost his its protons. Here I showed the positions without hydrogens, and the green circles showed the 6 remaining hydrogens. In this situation, the ground state of the complex at low temperatures was equal to 2, and at high temperatures it was equal to the spin of the complex was equal to 4. In this case, only one ferrum atom was undergoing, participating in the spin transition transformation with the change of temperature. And thus, this picture shows that qualitatively shows that with the addition of base, the number of the ferrum ions participation in the transition is decreasing. So we can come into our conclusions. The course of the spin crossover transformation in the linear complex was investigated in detail in the range of temperatures from 250 to 360 K. In this narrow temperature range, around 300 K, each ferrum ions in the trimer passes from the low spin diamagnetic state with the spin value to 1 to the state with the spin equal to 6. At the high temperature, confirmed complete spin crossover transformation. Performed single point energy calculation revealed that the spin crossover transformation observed experimentally probably occurs more rapidly in the two external ferrum ions. And the results of the performed single point DFT calculations showed that the protonated complex, fully protonated complex, only two ferrum ions participate in the spin crossover transformation. That is in line with the behaviors of magnetic susceptibility of this complex. And the protonation affects the local surrounding of the ferrum ions. And in this case, only one ferrum ion participates in the spin transition. And the performed single point calculations confirm that the protonation of the tetranuclear complex offers unique possibility to modulate the magnetic properties of the complex in a chemical way. Thank you for your attention.